Welcome back, everybody. It's Cree Rama from Junk Journal Divas.
Today is October 1st, so you know what that means if you follow me. The beginning of the month, I always have a new Diva Delight project. Before I announce the new project, I just want to show, if you follow me and you remember me making these journals, this is going to be the giveaway for September. So in September last month, I gave the free digital for the little houses, and it was so much fun to see all the different creations, all the different ways that people decorated the houses. So if you shared a picture in Junk Journal Divas, if you're not in the group, come on over. The link is in the video description. But people got one entry if you share a picture of your creation, and then you get another entry if you mail it out for happy mail for Diva Delights. So the drawing for this is going to be the second week in October. If you want to see the full flip through of this girl, I will add that link as well. But I have all my eco prints and dyed papers and lots of fun stuff, my tags, all the things that I have been working on. So there's a little bit of everything in here. Lots of fun. Look at that page. Okay, so again, the drawing for this is going to be live in Junk Journal Divas Facebook group, and that will be in 2 weeks. I just wanted to give people time to mail out their creations to other Diva Delight participants. Okay, so for October, I am going to be doing this 12 Days of Halloween. So this was created by Lisa Dodd, and she's one of my Diva sisters, so she shared this with me, and I thought it was just so much fun. So you can do this in any order that you want. It is just for a little bit of inspiration. So we've got Haunted House, Black Cats, Witch's Brew, Ghostly Apparitions, Pumpkins and Jack-O-Lanterns, Full Moon and Bats, Spooky Skeletons, Wicked Witches, Creepy Crawly Spiders, Halloween Candy, Vampire's Lair, and Graveyard at Midnight. So these are the 12 days, and you can do them in any order that you want, or just pick which ones you want to do. We also have a bunch of free digitals that you can use to help with inspiration for creating, including some from Art House Whimsy. So those are all in Junk Journal Divas Facebook group. And also, I'm going to put Lisa's information in the video description as well, so you can check her out and follow her also. And if you'd like a copy of this, I posted it on my YouTube channel. So if you go to, I think it says community, you can see all the posts that I've done, and I do have this posted. So there you can follow it and play along with me. So to start off, I have this cereal box that I cut, and I think I'm just going to gesso this and just kind of start with some backgrounds that I can use. So the idea with this is to make a, you can do whatever you want. You could take the prompt and do an art journal page. I will probably be doing tags or journal cards, whatever it is that you want to create. Artist choice. Let's start by putting a layer of gesso down on these, and we will go from there. Okay, so I'm starting off, I'm just doing a thin coat of gesso here, and if you have used gesso before, it dries pretty quickly. So just doing a thin coat, and then I'm going to flip it over and do the other side. So I'm going to start with number two, day two, which is Black Cats, because I just did all my haunted houses. So I'm going to skip to that one, and I've got these Black Cats. These are all from Art House Whimsy, and I'm gonna start by putting a little bit of embossing glaze on them since they're gonna be my focal points. I had this yellow. I might go over this one with the yellow and see what it looks like. Let's do that first. You guys, it's so funny. If you can see, I always have on, well, usually a black shirt because I'm in here and I always get messy. And why do I have on white today? You should see all the little splashes, tiny little dots from different things sticking to me. I should have known. Okay, so we're gonna use our embossing. This has the embossing ink in it. And this is the dauber. I use this quite often, but if you saw my last video, you can also get the embossing ink. It comes in like an ink pad, and you can also get a marker to do smaller little areas. But I'm gonna go over this whole thing, and I always do it. If I'm gonna do it this way, I do it before I cut out. It just makes it a lot easier. So let's put some on here. Tap it to the middle and then dump it in. Okay, so let's do this first and we'll see what the yellow looks like. So now I'm gonna use my heat gun to heat set this. Okay, so I really like this. So the yellow, it just kind of tints those, the eyes. Looks very cool. So I think I'll use the yellow on him, and then I'm gonna use clear on her because I don't want any tint on her since she's already perfect. So I'm gonna speed up the video here since we already went through this, but if you did not see my other video about embossing glaze, it's one of my favorite mediums, and I will link those videos. There's a part one and part two. I'll put those in the video description as well. So I use the yellow again, and now I'm just going to put some clear on top of her. And I just really love using this on my focal points. It just really makes the colors stand out, and it adds that little, that waxy kind of feeling to it. And I love this part, it's like magic. So here's what we have. And I love them. I think they turned out perfect. So I'm going to fussy cut these next. And I decided, since my backgrounds are going to be dark, I decided to kind of leave a little bit of the white so that my cats have a white outline. And also their little legs are pretty skinny. So it kind of helps with cutting those out also. Okay guys, I am back here the next day. I've got my black cats, I've got this one too. And then I saw these are also Art House Whimsy. You guys, I am trying to not print anything else because I have a whole file folder of just random pieces that are left over from things last year and also this year. So I'm really trying to not print anymore and use what I have. So I have these that I can use for 12 days of Halloween. I just covered a cereal box with my black gesso. And then I have these fabulous tags that I did previously, and These are included in one of my kits. I scanned them, but these are just, I love the backgrounds, the way they turned out. I just did a bunch of stamping and sprays and all kinds of messy fun. So I was thinking, there are 11 of these. I'm like, really? Are you kidding? If I had one more, I could do one of these tags for each day. That would be kind of fun just to keep for myself. So I was thinking that maybe I could do this black cat on one of these tags since he's kind of short. Could even do this one, it's even smaller, huh? So let's do some of these. Let's see. I'm gonna use these in the background. This would look kind of cool with her in the background. So let's just cut, I'm gonna cut these buildings out. So I am going to glue the buildings down for the backgrounds of these tags, and I think I'll use the two tall cats because they kind of look like they go together. So that is what we are going to do. I have a couple of die cuts and other things to play around with, and then we will meet back up at the end. Thank you.
Here's a look at the tags that we did together today. And if you want to get a copy of this list so that you can follow along with me and do your own creating, go to my channel and click on community, and then you will see the post that has a copy of the 12 Days of Haveline, so you can save it and do your own creating.